A million reasons to let you go. You're giving me a million reasons to quit the show. You're giving me a million reasons. Give me a million reasons. Giving me a million reasons. About a million reasons. If I had a highway, I would run for the hills. If you could find a dry way, I'd forever be still. But you're giving me a million reasons. Give me a million reasons. Giving me a million reasons. About a million reasons. I bow down to pray. I try to make the worst seem better. Lord, show me the way to cut through all this worn out leather. I got 100 million reasons to walk away. But baby, I just need one good one to stay.
All right. Namaste, gods, goddesses, and emissaries of light. This is Dr. Shreya Tayin, also known as Empress 1111. Welcome to my channel. If you are new, please click the like button, subscribe, and do not forget to click on the bell so you can get my latest updates for my videos. All right. For some of you that know me, you already know how I do it. Let me just go ahead and call in some help. And we can get right into the reading, okay? I call in air, fire, water, earth, spirit, and ether. I also call upon Yad-Heh-Vah-Heh in order for me to get the information that is necessary at this now moment in all directions in time and space for the evolution of your soul and my soul included. And so it is. All right. First of all, my throat is like going crazy trying to get this message out. Okay. Anytime you ever hear me clear my throat in the middle of giving a reading, it is because there's so much information that I have to project. And I clear my throat so I can clear the energy as I'm getting a lot of downloads on this reading. First of all, how you like my candle that I got from the Dollar Tree today? It's the chakra candle. I ended up getting two. Isn't that awesome? They pretty. And they're soy-based too, so it doesn't have the paraffins and the harmful chemicals and all that bad stuff, right? So, yeah. I thought those were pretty neat, and they also have throat chakra ones too, but they were all out of those, so these were the ones that were left. All right, so if you can see, look at my spread. I asked for divine guidance, and I asked for the divine to lay out the spread. Never in my life have I, since the history of doing readings, ever in my life had a spread like this. Talk about sacred geometry. Talking about organization, right? I mean, these cards are laid out so perfectly. All right, let's go ahead and get right into this reading. Crowning your reading, you have the Princess of Swords. And what I'm feeling for some of you with this card. Wow. Okay. You've been on this constant battle and you have your guard up. I'm sensing you really have your guard up. Man, the reason why I paused for a while is because Source told me to play that song. And I am feeling that this is coming from the divine feminine. She has exhausted all of her avenues. She has exhausted all her resources. She has played over and over and over again in her mind why she should stay in this union. And now the synchronicity to Lady Gaga, Million Reasons, and this bread, I am now starting to understand and overstand why I was inclined to choose this song. And I'm going to tell you, I have not looked at the cards. I just laid them down. I haven't put in my mind what type of interpretation that this is going to be as of yet, but I can feel the heavy energy, and I can tell that someone's been doing a lot of thinking, a lot of back and forth energy is what I'm feeling from this card. Wondering, should they stay? Should they go? Wondering, when is the divine masculine going to show up in a relationship? Next, we have the Six of Cups. Now, I'm feeling that this energy is coming from the divine masculine. The divine masculine is coming back for a reconciliation, okay? But right now, you see this? This represents the divine feminine. This represents the divine masculine. Normally, the divine masculine is at the top, but this source laid this spread out. I was guided by source to lay this spread out. This is not my spread. This is a divine spread coming from the divine directly. Okay. So the rules of engagement changes when source takes control. So do you see how the tarot card is connected to both? It's right next to the divine feminine and is right on top of the divine masculine, which leads me to believe that heaven has stepped in. This has been a divine intervention and is awakening the divine masculine, okay? The divine feminine, she's off already to the side. She's already had her awakening, okay? But there has been some epiphanies and there has been some endings in the relationship between the two. She has been asked to change her trajectory and her direction because for the longest, she's been in this back and forth energy with the divine masculine. But the divine masculine was limping onto opinions because he has not yet, at that point of time, recognized his autonomy and his sovereignty, and he has not fully came into his calling and his divine purpose. It seems like for some of these divine masculines, they were heavily attached to the earthly realm. Okay. And so source had to do a divine shakeup. As you can see, the king lost his crown. Now the universe is repositioning. Both the divine feminine and the divine masculine are being repositioned. Okay. Let's see what's next. The Nine of Pentacles. Since this is next to the divine masculine, I am going to say that this is in reference to the divine masculine. He is basically happy about his wealth that he's accumulated and his coins. This is what has been distracting him from the union. He's been more fixed on his wealth and his accumulation of it. Yeah, that's exactly what I'm picking up. Then you have the Hermit card, okay? Now, remember, this card right here is representing the divine masculine energy is what I'm feeling. So he's put himself in isolation, not only from his divine feminine, but for the rest of the world as well. No one really has access to him at this point because he's doing some introspection and he's going deep inside trying to figure out why the hell this just happened, this tarot moment. The divine masculine is starting to get insights because now he's starting to piece together the signs that the universe has been giving him in reference to the union with the divine feminine. He's starting to awaken to what this union is really all about. And now he's in the state of confusion because now he's accumulated all this money at a place where really he's not even supposed to be, but he's here. This is all a part of the journey. This is his free will, his free choice. This is the path that he chose. There are many roads. There are many paths. This is the path that he chose. And there really is no right and there's no wrong. But this is definitely not the divine path, although he was blessed along the way. Then you have the Ace of Swords. This makes perfect sense because you have the reconciliation card. And the Ace of Swords means that he's going to come in with the offer quicker. I'm seeing that this offer is going to really take some of the divine feminines by surprise. They have no clue that the divine masculine is really in the state of silence, working his way back to her. Even though he isolated himself for a reason. And that reason being is yet to be determined because I haven't looked at the rest of the cards. I love it. All right. So you have the Six of Wands here. I haven't really got a chance to fully play with this deck in its entirety. Oh, okay. So there's been a lot of gossiping that's been going on about you, Divine Feminine. There's been a lot of people in the Divine Masculine ear about you. That's what I'm picking up with this card. Okay? This is the way I'm interpreting it because this is the way that it's coming to me from the Divine. There's some people that's been in his ear about you. Some gossiping. Some backbiting. And these are his people. These people are connected to him. And they're trying their very best to detour him from coming back to you. It's more than one person. You got some haters. This is a hater card. You got some haters. You got some people that are stalking your social media and going back and telling your divine masculine what the hell you've been posting. They are clocking your every move, Divine Feminine, and they're reporting it right back to the Divine Masculine. But have no fear, because right now he's breaking away from the old paradigm and the old 3D way of thinking as far as relationships are concerned. He does not give a ding, dang, gong, dang, ding, dang it about what any of these people have to say, because no one can separate you from true love. Nothing real can be threatened. So they can try all they want to. These are just some bitter bitties, okay? Some bitter people that are disappointed with their own lot in life. And so they feel that the more that they are in your divine masculine ear about you, that the more likely that he doesn't want to be with you. But they don't realize he's already made up his mind. He's working on coming back. He's just waiting for a perfect moment to where he can finally get his heart and his mind connected and on one page, because he's still dealing with some ego. Okay. How do I know that? Because you have the Death card. He still is waiting for the death of the ego here. This is what this card is representing in this spread. Okay. One thing I want to let you know is that the tarot, and when you're doing tarot reading, the cards take on new meaning based off of the cards that are around them. Okay. So since we're talking about him changing the old paradigms and the way of doing things and doing things in a non-orthodox way. And then you have the Death card. That's representing the death of the ego. I can't make this stuff up. This is before I even seen that this card was even laying next to it. Then you have the Ace of Wands. The Divine Masculine, he's really wanting to give you communication, but the reason why he's not coming in quick with the communication, because I want to get this out, and man, the energy behind it is just phenomenal. He's wanting to open up communication, but he's not stupid. He know he basically did a mind fuck on you, okay? He really hurt you. He's guilty. So he's very careful about what he's going to come in with as far as how he's going to approach you. How do I know this? Because you have the moon card upside down. This is going to reveal some secrets. He's going to come and tell you the real reason why you've been in separation, the real reason why he left you. You are going to get justice. You're going to find this out. That's the reason why you have the moon in reverse. If it was the other way, that means it would have been still hidden. But it looks like that you have the universe conspiring for you. He's coming in with that information. He's going to tell you. Either he's going to tell you or someone, because this is a general reading. I'm not doing a personal reading. If I was doing a personal reading, honey, I could have gave you the nicks and the cranny, the ins and the out. I could have laid down all kind of cards around here to get this information. But right now, I had to keep it generalized. If you want the extended version, we can go into deeper depth about this situation. But either he's going to tell you or someone is going to come out, okay? The angels are going to reveal it to you either through him or through someone that you guys know, like a mutual party. Don't matter how you get the information. You're going to get it. All right. And then you have the Three of Pentacles in reverse, okay? Now, this is a good sign if it was upright, but it's in reverse. So, what I'm sensing from this card, when the Divine Masculine comes back, he's going to be a work in progress. Although he's not going to come back the same way that he left, he has been making some changes, but they're still going to be, he's still going to be rough around the edges, Divine Feminines. Be patient with him because he's new to all of this. This is a spiritual awakening for him. He is at the beginning of his spiritual awakening. Like in time past, he thought that he really had a handle on spirituality when he really did not. And the reason why is because he was full of ego. So it wasn't able to take root the way that it normally could if he wasn't edging God out. Okay? Then you have the Two of Swords, Divine Feminine. You're still feeling conflicted. You're still feeling like, you know, what should I do about this situation? And it could be a self confliction. It could be a self illusion too. It may not even have anything to do with the Divine Masculine and why you're feeling conflicted. Maybe you can feel conflicted because you're not truly trusting your intuition 100%. Whatever the case is, the Divine Masculine. Wow, this is a really deep reading. The Divine Masculine is coming back. This is the Six of Swords. He's coming back really quick. He's traveling over water. You see this? I can't make this stuff up. Okay? He may come by an airplane. He may come in a vehicle. It just basically represents distance. You're definitely not in union with your Divine Masculine at this moment. Okay? And you're not separated, but he still lives in the same house. No, you guys are separated, far apart. And he's coming back. And he's coming back quick. This is the Six of Swords, you guys. The cards do not lie. This man, this Divine Masculine, he had a death to his ego. See that? His ego is dead. I'm not saying that he can't resurrect it. Okay? But as far as who he used to be, he's definitely not the narcissist that he used to be. Not saying that he still don't have some narcissistic traits. Okay. What I'm getting overall from this spread is that there was some painful lessons learned here, not only for the Divine Feminine, but for the Divine Masculine too, because it was enough to wake him up to his senses to even think about contemplating coming back into union, because he had his tired moment, because when he had the end of the relationship with the karmic, which is what he is now dealing with, and that's the truth of why he's not communicating with you, he's hurt because he really thought that that was the one, because he gave you up for her and she hurt him. Okay, she went back to her ex, which left him out in the cold. He has all the money, but he doesn't have love. That's the reason why he went back into contemplation and in isolation. Let's pull some more cards. I can't make this stuff up. Why did he have a tire moment, Source? Why did he have a tire moment, Source? I just laid that card down here. Didn't I say divine intervention? This is divine intervention. That's because this is a course correction for him to get right back on his path. Okay? Source loves you, divine feminine. Source has heard your cries, seen your pain that the divine masculine has inflicted upon you when he was just being a masculine. Okay? And because of that, the scales of judgment, the scales of karma came to balance this out through the karmic. The judgment card represents karma. So he got his karma. He met his karma, and that's why it happened. All right. So if you want to know in further detail how this story turns around, how he's coming in, how quick he's coming in, a projection of when he's coming in, you can purchase the extended version for $11.11. I will upload it to my private videos. And once you contact me and tell me you want it, I will give you the link and access to it immediately. Okay. Soon as I get your text and my email, I will give it to you. I am on Eastern Standard Time. So if you text me anytime after I do this broadcast, chances are you won't get it anytime soon because I'm about to go to sleep. But you will get this within 24 hours or when I wake up and I see that you have it there, I will get it to you because I have already done the extended version and it's going to be ready for you. All right. It is a good karma too. Like, share, comment, subscribe, donate if you feel inclined to. I also have a gift registry with Amazon. If you would like to purchase something there to show up on a channel, that is fine too. I now wrap you in my love and I cloak you with the light of Christ consciousness. Thank you, everyone. Namaste. And so it is.